Hello, good morning everyone. Today we'll discuss about the third module in the TQM, that is customer satisfactions and employee involvement. So let's talk about the topic. So what are the contents? The contents are as follows. It includes the customer focus, customer orientation, customer satisfaction, customer complaints, customer retention. This will be the one part, and the second part will be of employee involvement. The employee involvement contains the motivation for the employees, empowerment, team and teamwork, recognitions and rewards, and performance appraisals. So let's talk about the customer focus, customer orientations and the customer satisfactions. Okay, so let's, what the customer? The customer is a king. All you know that when you visit the any shops, you will see the board, the customer is God, the customer is a king. So why it is all written? It is written because we need to treat the customers very respectfully. We'll be treating as a guest or the purpose or the person who is going to improve our business. The customer is a king, first point, as I had said. Second point is the quality is what the customer wants. So anybody, the customer is going to purchase, he will be seeing the first one is quality. So what is quality? So quality is defined as the ratio of performance by expectations. Okay, so this is the one way of measuring the customer satisfactions. If the quality is good, if the ratio of P by E, that is performance by expectation, is greater than 1, then we can say that the quality is good and customer is well satisfied. Okay, the business cannot survive without the satisfied customers. If you want to run the business, if you want to run the any organizations, we need to satisfy the customers first, because they are the one who are going to tell to others because about the companies, about the business, about the service to the outside world. So therefore we need to treat the customers, we need to satisfy the customers very first beginning. So therefore the TQM is the purpose is that meeting or exceeding the customer expectations, and more than that, surprising the customers is the competitive advantages. If you are surprising your customers with the more of facilities, more of their meeting, more than their expectation, there will be the competitive advantages in the market. Next we'll see the tables model of customer satisfactions. What is this customer satisfaction model? So it looks like a square with a circle which is intersected. In this, so it is the intersection of company offers and customer needs will leads to the customer satisfactions. If the both are get intersected, both are meeting the requirements, okay, then it is going to be satisfied for the business. So who are the customers? The customers are the most important people in the business. Without them, we can't run any organizations. They are not dependent on the organizations, but the organization depend on them. Without the customers, we can't run any business. They are not an interruption to the work. Okay, they are the purpose of it. We are running only because of the customers. Also, they are not the outsiders, they are the part of a business who will be the, they are also be called as the lifeblood of the business, because they'll be telling the feedbacks, they'll be giving the suggestions, and they are deserves the most courteous, that is nothing but respectful and attentive treatment for their suggestions, for their ideas, for the improvement of the product. Let's talk about the, there will be types of customers. Okay, so the customers will be classified under two categories, that are internal customers and external customers. So let's study who are internal customers. They are the individuals or the divisions or the employees who purchase the product of the company or the organization, and they are the part of the companies. They are being the part of the companies in one or other ways. Next, they may be mediators or the common between the customers and the companies. So they'll be knowing the product, they know knowing about the processes, and they'll be purchasing the product in a cheaper rates. Next, who are external customers? External customers are the one, they are the outside the company, they are not belongs to the companies. So they are the one who uses our product or the services. So who purchase our product or services, who influence the sale of the product or services, they are all called as external customers. So next we see the customer supplier chain, how the customer and this chain will be continued. So as we are seeing in the diagram, so input from the external customers, whatever the inputs, whatever the suggestions are there, that can be taken out to the internal customers or the persons who are using inside the companies, and again that will be circulated to the external customers with their adding all the suggestions, all the feedbacks to the customers. Let's talk about next, customer perception of quality. So what they think, how, on what parameters the customers are going to decide about the product. As per the American Society for Quality, that is nothing but ASQ, surveyed, ranked the customer perceptions in following order. Okay, so they are going to treat the quality in this concept. First one is the performance. What is performance? It is nothing but a fitness for use. It is the product, if any product, it is capable to give the fit for the use, then they will be calling it performance is good. Next, what are the features? It will be nothing but a features. In this parameters, we'll be calling it as a feature. For example, if you consider a watch, the primary functionality will be the time, showing the time. But if you are considering the other features, like if it is providing a heartbeat, if it is providing your sleeping time, so that will be the considered as additional features, as we are having these things in a Mi Band. So similarly, services, if the company is giving ready to give the good services for the companies, for the customers, so then it will be calling as a good quality. So next is a warranty. What is warranty? If any customers is given a promise from the business people or the organization or the any companies, the warranty is about the product. If it is 1 year, 2 year, depend on the manufacturer's details. If the warranty is said, so in within that warranty, the company has to give the services, and it should not be failure within that field. If that product is getting failure, the company has to make the good services of the product. Next, about the people, will see about the price. So price is what? It is a worth for the money. Are we paying the good amount for our product? So that will matters for the customers. Next, reputations. So how the reputation of the company, how the brand is there in the market? Are they producing good products in the societies? So what is their reputation? How they are standing in the market? So that is also matters in these things. Next, we'll see about the customer complaints. Before to that, we'll go for the customer feedbacks. So customer, why the customer feedbacks are so important? So because customers are the one who are going to use our products, they are going to tell about the products, how it is going to working, what other things we need to add, so that we will be having better products in the market. So if you see this details, total satisfied customers contributes 2.6 times as much as revenue to the company. Somewhat satisfied customers, if the more satisfied is there, he'll be contributing more 2.6 than the somewhat satisfied customers. They'll be different, fully satisfied and somewhat satisfied, so they'll be different. So if the more totally satisfied, customer will be contributing 2.6 times because he will be telling about the products to the other peoples. Next point, if you see the next point, the totally satisfied customers. See this. Totally satisfied customer contributes 17 times as much revenue as somewhat dissatisfied customers. Okay. So here, the satisfied customers, if you are having a more number of satisfied customers, will be generating 17 times than the dissatisfied customers. Next, if you see the third point, a total dissatisfied customer, underline this, the dissatisfied customer decreases the revenue, of the company, revenue of the organizations at a rate equal to 1.8 times of what satisfied customer contribute to business. They are the dissatisfied customers are going to reduce the revenue of the companies. In order to reduce the number of dissatisfied customers, we need to have the customer feedbacks. Customer feedbacks must be continuously monitored, regulated. Okay. Therefore, the customer feedbacks are very important. So, as we have studied why the customer feedbacks are required. The customer feedbacks of a customer complaints is required. The first point is to discover the customer dissatisfactions. Why the people are not getting satisfied? Where we are failing? Okay. Why the company is not meeting the requirements? Next point, to identify the customer needs, what they want. Okay. The feedbacks are very, very important in any organizations because the customers are the one who are going to use our services, who use our products. So we need to identify the customer needs. Next, to discover relative priorities of qualities. Okay. So whether we are meeting all the quality goals or not. Okay. So which are as per the quality parameters, whether we are meeting or not, we have to see that. Okay. To compare, next point, to compare performance with the competitions. Okay. How our products are there with the other competitors in the market. If the same bikes are there, but what is the difference in the our products and the other competitors? Okay. So in order to know all these things, we should have a customer feedbacks. To determine the opportunities for improvement. So what are the things are there, how to improve for the product services. For all these things, the customer feedbacks are very, very essential. Next, how to collect this all customer complaints? What are the tools for collecting the customer complaints? So we are having the certain tools over here in this slide. There are the comment cards. Next one is the customer questionnaires. Next is a focus group. Next is a toll-free telephone number, customer visits, report cards, next the internet and the computers, and employee feedbacks. Okay, what is the comment card? The comment card will be there. Okay, the customer are asked to write the comments about the product, how they are feeling, what are the things, about the things, what we need to add in the product. That are all to be mentioned in the, they will be asked by the companies to the customers about their products. Next is the customer questionnaires. What is this customer questionnaires? By asking, the company will ask certain set of questions to the customers after the couple of days of using the product. So that questions will tell us whether the customer is satisfied or not. Okay. With that questions, the certain set of questions will tell us about the customer satisfactions. Next, focus group. What are the focus group? It is the group of people who are using the product. It will be varying between the 5 to 10 people. So there we are going to discuss about the, we'll be considering a group of people We'll be discussing about the product, how it has been useful, whether it is a moderate for the use, whether it is good or excellent, or such kind of a discussion will be taken out, and finally come with the conclusion that this product is worth in the market. Next is customer visits. Meeting the customers one by one, okay, so asking them, meeting with their personal things, meeting with the products details. So one is like one-on-one interviews will be typically provide the quantitative informations that do not be generated in the larger populations. So this will be the one advantage that the customer will openly tells about the products, complaints, improvements and services, all this can be modified. So next, report cards. Are the report cards are the ones which are including all the details, how the services of the company is there, how the people of companies are responding. All these things are going to be highlighted in the report cards. So next, the internet and the computers. Nowadays we are having the internet and the blogs. They will tell you, they will give you links, and that will be useful for the customer feedbacks. Next, as well as employee feedbacks. Employee feedbacks, because they are the ones to make the modification in the products. So their feedbacks is also very, very important. So next will be the chart as shown in the how this entire process of feedbacks takes place with the diagram is shown in this slide. Next, the service quality. The customer service is set of activities an organization uses to satisfy the customers and their needs. Okay, the service quality will be there. Okay, 1 year of service quality. If you purchase any material, any vehicles, they will give you the service quality, okay, in order to make the during before the sale of the product. It will be given you when it will be given, it will be provided the before the sale of the product, during the sale, even after the sale also it is being provided. Next, so elements of customer service. Jacques Horowitz and Chan Kudenkpoon have listed the 25 elements of customer services. Okay, for the organizations, there as well, for the organizations, what organization has to do for the customer services. So identify each market segments. So what presently market is going on, what the need of the market. So you have to identify with the all the surveys, making a group surveys, all these things, it has to identify the market segment. And next, organization has to write down all the requirements. What is the present requirement of the customers, what they need actually, and communicate the requirements. We have to communicate with the customers, communicate with the group of people with the requirement, what they required actually. So after this, organize all the processes for the meeting the requirements, organize physical spaces for the meeting requirements. So this is a one part on the organization side. Next, on second, on the customer care. So we have to meet the customer expectations, then only the customers are going to rate us with a good star, a good number of marks to the our products. Get the customer point of view. We have to get the customer point, what he want actually. So let's deliver what is promised. Some companies will tell something and deliver something. Due to this, the customer will be dissatisfied. So first, whatever we are telling, so that has to be delivered, then only the customer is going to be satisfied, keeping the promises in the point of customers. Make the customer feel valued. We have to make the customer, we have to listen to the customers, we have to respect the customers, and we have to respond to all the complaints. it may be small or big, whatever it is there, we have to respond to the all the customer complaints. Then only the customers get satisfied. Over respond to the customers. We have to respond to the customer always, again and again, for the our product services. Provide a clean and comfortable customer reception areas where platform will be given or the area will be given for the customer satisfactions, customer feedbacks. Next is, third element is communications. There will be communication is a very essential part between the customers and companies. Optimize the trade-off between time and personal attentions. So you have to make the optimize the trade-off between time and personal attentions. We have to give the personal attention to the customer feedbacks. Minimize the number of contact points. So you have to minimize the number of contact points. Provide pleasant knowledge and enthusiastic employees. Whenever the salespersons are there, they will be pleasant one. They should not be any harsh. And they know about the depth of product, knowledge about the product, and enthusiastic employees should be there. Write the documents in customer friendly languages. The customer are good in their languages. So we have to write the documentation. Documentation is a very essential one for the recording purpose. We have to record all the things, either it may be a recording, video recording, audio recording, it may be paragraphs. There will be written recordings. These things will be used in the customer services. Next, frontline peoples. Hire the peoples who like peoples. So this is one point where the we are ready to communicate, we are going to like the peoples, are ready to give the services. Hire those people. Challenge them to develop better methods. We have to have the giving them task, make the customer more happier. Give them an authority to solve the problems also. Okay. So whatever where the people are been hired, give them authority, make them perfect. Make them to solve the problems very properly. Serve them as an internal customers. Treat them as a custom internal customers because they are the one to tell the defects in the products about the companies. Be sure they are adequately trained. So internal customers are adequately means sufficiently trained. They know about the things of the companies. Recognize and reward the performance. You have to recognize the efforts made by the employees, effort made by the internal customers to make the products excellent in the market. Okay, so you have to make them, their performance should be measured in terms of rewards, in terms of bonus, such kinds of things. Next element is leadership. Lead by the examples. So you'll be the leader in the market. Listen to the frontline peoples. So frontline peoples are the one to make the products better and better. Strive for continuous improvement. Okay. So this is the main aim in the TQM where it is striving, it is continuously doing for continuous improvement in the process. Next, we'll see that customer retentions. What is customer retention? Retaining the customer for the our company's product. The customer has to buy our product again and again. Okay. The customer retention is a process of retaining the existing customers. Okay. It is a process where it is a very toughest job in the present scenario, but it has to be done. Okay. Okay, retaining the existing customer care ensures that customer is not only satisfied but also retained. Okay, customers who are satisfied will retain with the companies always. A study reveals that over 60% of an organization's future revenue will come from the existing customers. It has been made, it has been a statistical number, over 60%, more than the 60% of the organization's future revenue. So how you act will be depends on the present existing customers. If you are treating your existing customers very good, then your future revenue will be excellent. Second point, next point, a 2% increase in customer retention has an equivalent impact upon profitability as a 10% reduction operating cost. So if you are keeping 2% increase in a customer retention, so that is will be equivalent to 10% reduction in the operating cost. What is operating cost? Getting the customers, knowing the customers, okay, like marketing strategies, that cannot, that all the costs can be reduced if you're having 2% of retention in the customers. So next, up to 96% of unhappy customers do not complain, in fact. But they are the 3 times more likely to communicate a bad experience to the other customers than a good one. So because if the product is very bad, if the service is bad, they will tell to 96 more than peoples. Okay, it will be like mouth publishings. So next is 91% of unhappy customers will never purchase goods and service from you again. Okay, once the trust has been lost upon the companies, the customer will not come to your shop, your organization to buy your product, to invest money in you, all these things. If you make an effort to remedy customers' complaints, okay, if you are seriously making an effort to solve these customer complaints, okay, so then the 80 to 95% of them will stay on with you. Okay. So it is of a very, very, very important in the customer retentions. We need to solve the customer complaints. Then only we can have the customer retentions. It costs 5 times as much to attract new customers. Okay. It will be, if you are keeping these people's, it will be helpful for you to attract still more customers, and it will be keeping one less cost to you. It's a very old one method. Okay. Next, customer retention represent an activities that produce a necessary customer satisfaction that creates customer loyalty. Okay, if you're having a customer retentions, okay, so it not only create a customer satisfaction, it's also a loyalty between the customers and the companies. It's like honest true relationship between will be developed between the customers and the companies. Customer retention can be improved by obtaining customer feedbacks and by customer measuring customer satisfactions. So we can improve by the customer feedbacks. We already learned about the feedback methods. Okay, so with this we can have the customer satisfactions. Customer feedback is obtained from customer satisfaction surveys, focus group interviews, observations. All these will help to retain the customers, to know about the customer complaints. Next, customer retention really moves the customer satisfaction to the next level, is called as customer delight. Customer delight means customer is happy. So this is all about our session. In next sessions, we'll be discussing about the employee involvement, how the employee involvement is very essential in the product development of the companies.